somebody should tell us right at the start of our lives that we're dying. Then we might live life to the limit. Every minute of every day. Whatever you want to do, do it now. There are only so many tomorrows. I say to you that if you're driven by anything other than your love, than your spirit, your desire to grow and expand, if you're driven by your need to please others, if you're driven by your fear, if you're driven by your past, it's time to free yourself. And the way to do it is decide. Decide consciously what you want your life to be about.
Our life is dynamic. It's constantly changing. But it comes with the decision that you're going to divorce the story of your past, the lies you've been telling yourself that you should change, and you're going to enter into this new life where you must change. You're going to go from that should to a must. So why don't you start today? Why don't you make a decision that you're not going to be this person anymore, and you are going to be on a new path with the decision that you make today.
We'll be right back. someone told me that something is impossible, I will go out and do it. That's just the way I always was. I was told to my face, you're nothing but a giant muscle. You can't act. You have no future and you have an accent that is laughable. Ignore the naysayers. Work like hell. Trust yourself. Break some rules. Don't be afraid to fail. I've made a fortune in several careers, and I've been very successful in several careers by believing in myself. Let me tell you, you're going to find the naysayers at every turn that you make. Don't listen. Just visualize your goal, know exactly where you want to go. Trust yourself. Get out there and work like hell. And break some of the rules and never, ever be afraid of failure. I couldn't have gone to one lifting event in my life if I would have been afraid of failure. Because of course there's a chance that you can fail. When you lift the weight, I tried 10 times to lift bench press 500 pounds. And I failed. But the 11th time I did it. So never give up and never be afraid of failure, because otherwise you box yourself in and you limit yourself. You all should go and be hungry for success. You should be hungry to make your mark, and you should be hungry to be seen and to be heard and to have an effect out there. You have to think outside the box. That's what I believe, after all. What is the point of being on this earth if all you want to do is be liked by everyone and avoid trouble? The only way that I ever got any place was by breaking some of the rules. When you're out there partying, horsing around, someone out there at the same time is working hard. Someone is getting smarter and someone is winning. Just remember that. Now, if you want to coast through life, don't pay any attention to any of those rules. But if you want to win, there's absolutely no way around hard, hard work.
What is it that you looked at some point in time and you decided that you couldn't do it? That you talked yourself out of it? Whatever it is, bring it back out there. How are you going to do it? That will come to you in due time. See, you don't get in life what you want, ladies and gentlemen. You get in life what you are, not what you want. See, the good news is that we can always become more by working to develop ourselves. So the first process of making this your decade, you've got to begin to take a look at your life and look at where are you right now? What are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? What gives your life a sense of fulfillment, a sense of joy? What does a full, rich life mean to you? What is it that you can love doing 7 days a week that'll bring a smile to your face? I want you to look at your life right now and think about something that's important to you, something that gives your life a sense of value. Think about something that you'd like to have or something you'd like to create for you or your family or for society. I want you to hold this thought in mind. Now, one of the first things I want you to do is don't worry about the inner conversation that you're going to have. Don't worry about how you're going to do it. That's going to come. You're going to develop a plan of action. You will find the way. You'll become the kind of person that can attract the people, the resources, and everything you need in order to make that become reality.
If you help enough people get what they want, you can have everything.
Let's keep it real. If it was easy, everybody would do it.
When you're working at your dream, somebody said, the harder the battle, the sweeter the victory. Oh, it's sweet to you. It's good to you. Why? See, when it's hard and there's a struggle, see, what you become in the process is more important than the dream. That's far more important. The kind of person you become, the character that you build, the courage that you develop, the faith that you're manifesting. Oh, it's something that you get up in the morning, you look yourself in the mirror, you're a different kind of person. You walk with a different kind of person.
Remember the six rules.
Trust yourself.
Break some rules. Don't be afraid to fail. Ignore the naysayers. Look like hell and give something back.